guys, welcome back to Fresh OB. So in today's video, we'll talk about the complete information about the TCS interview procedure. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the interview panel, like how many interviewers will be there, like the duration for the interview, what kind of questions they ask during the interview based on the stream of the candidate. So we'll see top 100 questions related to the technical, managerial and HR round which are included in the TCS interview procedure. We will also see the importance of CV and based on the stream of the candidate how the questions will be varying. So we'll also see that. So this is going to be a very informative video for all the candidates. So please don't skip the video in between and watch the video till the end so that you can get a complete and clean idea about TCS interview process, like how things go in the interview cabin. So we'll discuss all the things. So stay tuned and let's begin today's video. So the TCS interview mainly includes total 3 interviewers. One will take your technical interview, second one will take your managerial interview, and the last one will be the HR one. So this interview process includes total 3 interviewers, and the difficulty level for the interview will be varying from like medium to hard based on the candidates and based on the interviewer. So it will vary, and the marking scheme will be out of 10. So all the interviewers will rate the candidate based on the performance out of 10. So this will be the marking scheme. And coding questions, yes, like it may be possible, like mostly they ask basic questions related to the coding. Technical interviewer will ask you questions related to the coding, and the duration will be 25 minutes. Like this is like a approximate duration, like based on the candidate and interviewer the duration will vary. So next we'll see like what kind of things one should prepare for the interview, like based on the streams we'll discuss one by one. So firstly we'll see for computer science, IT, MCA and other coding domain streams. So try to stick to technologies and languages mentioned in your CV. So make sure you are good with all the things like the technologies and the programming languages you have mentioned in your CV. So you should stick to those technologies and languages, and basic questions on C, OOPS and software engineering, DSA, that is you will necessarily be asked questions from this, like whatever you have mentioned in your CV, things related to that they will ask you. And third one is if your CV mentions the any of the following, like basic questions on DBMS, computer networks, operating systems, then ask questions on the same. So like they for all the coding domain students, like questions on computer network, operating systems and basic questions on DBMS are expected. And last one is ask questions about final year project. This is also a very important point, like you have to mention all the mini projects and final year project you have done in your CV. So it will be like a plus point to all the candidates, like if you mention your project in your CV, then definitely the interviewer is going to ask you questions on your project. So make sure you have mentioned your project in your CV. So next one is for non-coding branches like electronics and mechanical, civil. So very first point is stick to technologies and languages mentioned in your CV. So this point is similar in coding streams and non-coding streams. You have to make sure you have whatever you have mentioned in your CV, you are good with all the technologies and languages. So this is very important point. And the next one is very basic questions on C, OOPS, the programming languages mentioned in your CV. Like the interviewer will definitely consider if you are a non-IT student, then definitely he will ask you like the basic questions, very basic questions he will ask you based on the technologies and languages you have mentioned in your CV. And third will be like talk about your final year projects. like whatever things you have done, like circuit diagrams, formulas, definitions, only from topics related to final year projects of his or her respective branch. Like, the interviewer will definitely tend to ask you questions on your final year project, so make sure you are good with all the minor concepts related to your final year projects so that you can give proper answers to all the questions which the interviewer will ask you. And also make sure you are good with all the circuit diagrams and the formulas and definitions related to your projects and all the basic concepts and the minor details related to your projects. You should be good with all these things. Fourth one is ask about his favorite subject and ask basic questions on it. Like, this is a very important point. Like, even for coding stream students and non-coding stream students, the interviewer can ask you, like, tell me what was your favorite subject, like, in your academics. So if you tell him any of the subjects, then he will definitely ask you questions on that particular subject. And make sure if you are telling any subject to the interviewer, like, this was my favorite subject in my academics, then definitely make sure you are good with all the basics things about that subject so that you can answer properly to all the questions which the interviewer will ask you. So next we'll talk about the CV. Like, resume is one of the most important thing in TCS, like, not in TCS but everywhere, wherever you will go to give your interview, so your CV will be the most important part. And since they will first check your CV and ask questions based on the languages, projects, technologies that you have mentioned in your CV, so you have to write a TCS specific introduction in CV on why you want to work for them and why you are a good match for them. It leaves a very good impression on the interviewer that you are not using the same CV everywhere but created one specifically for TCS, and thus you are excited to join TCS. He will give a preference to you. So make sure you make a different CV for TCS specific introduction. And the second one will be like, write a short CV, like about max 1 to 1.5 pages, not more than that. Since the interviewer doesn't want to read so much information, so make sure your CV should be like max 1 or 1.5 page long. And always mention some sports or extracurricular achievements that you have done. And this shows that you are a hardworking and active person who will be more responsive at work. So make sure you have mentioned all the things related to your sports and extracurricular achievements you have done. And do not mention anything that you don't know completely. Like, this is a very like important thing. Like, if you don't know anything, then please don't mention that thing on your CV. Always write about your final year projects so they can ask you questions about something that you already know completely about. And make sure that you know most diagrams, theories and definition and all the basic concepts related to your project. And write about languages, technologies and subjects you know so he can ask you questions from that. So in your CV, your main aim is to provide him a hint about the subject you want him to ask questions from, rather than him thinking from which subject should he ask questions. So if he reads C or DBMS written in your CV, then he will definitely ask you questions from that. And well, prepare for both subject really well so that you can answer all the questions that the interviewer will ask you. I hope you guys are getting my point. Like, the CV will play a major role in your interview. Like, whatever things you have mentioned in your CV, the interviewer is going to ask you questions from that particular points. So make sure you are extremely good with your CV. So moving forward, So next we will discuss like the most common questions from all the rounds like TR, MR and HR. So we will discuss all these questions one by one. So very firstly we'll talk about the technical round questions. So I have taken like around 10 to 12 questions. So the very first question is, what is your strongest programming language? Java, ASP, CPP. So here is a point to remember. Before interview, you should decide your favorite programming language and be prepared questions based on the same. So before the interview, make sure you are good with any one of the programming language and mention that on your CV so that the interviewer will tend to ask you questions on that particular programming language. Second question is difference between C and Java. So we'll see its answer too. Like Java is object oriented while C is procedural. And second one is Java is interpreted language while C is a compiled language. C is a low level language while Java is a high level language. And fourth one is C uses the top down approach while Java uses the bottom up approach. Fifth point is pointer go backstage in Java while C requires explicit handling of pointers. So this is the answer for this particular question. So next question is, in header files where the functions are declared or defined. So answer for the same is, like, functions are declared within header file, that is function prototypes exist in a header file, not function bodies. They are defined in library. And fourth question is, what are the different storage classes in C? So there are total four types of storage classes in C. They are external, register, auto and static. Fifth question is, how do you print an address? Like using %p in printf to print the address. So this is the way to print the address. So sixth question is, what does static variable mean? Static is an access specific qualifier. If a variable is declared as static inside a function, the scope is limited to the function, but it will exist for the lifetime of the program. Values will be persisted between successive calls to a function. And seventh question is, what are macros? What are its advantages and disadvantages? So answer for the same is, macros are processor directive which will be replaced at compile time. The disadvantage with macros is that they just replace the code that are not function calls. Similarly, the advantage is they can reduce time for replacing the same values. So the eighth question is, difference between pass by reference and pass by values. This is the very famous question. Like definitely they will ask you this question, like, what is the difference between pass by value and pass by reference? So the answer for this question is, pass by value just passes the value from caller to calling function. So the called function cannot modify the values in caller function, but pass by reference will pass the address to the caller function instead of value. If called function requires to modify any value, it can directly modify. So ninth one is, what is an object? Object is a software bundle of variable and related methods. Object have state and behavior. So this is the answer for the question, what is an object? And the last question is, what is a friend function? A friend function for a class is used in OOP to allow access to public, private or protected data in the class from the outside. So here is a list for some more technical round questions, so you can take a screenshot of the same. So I will just read out all the questions one by one. So question is, like, write a binary search program. What is Java applet? What are the different storage classes in C? Advantages of a macro over a function. What is command line argument? Sixth one is, what is data abstraction? What are the three levels of data abstraction with example? And seventh one is, what is a doubly linked list? Eighth one is, what is insertion sort, selection sort, double sort? So you have to prepare all these basic things like sorting and the types of sorting. What are linked list, the types of linked list? And ninth one is, what are the two integrity rules used in DBMS? So here are some more questions. You can take a screenshot. And questions are like, tell something about deadlock and how can we prevent deadlock. Second is, what are the advantages of inheritance? Third one is, what is data structure? Fourth is, what is the difference between relock and free? And fifth one is, what do you mean by inline function? Sixth is, what is scope of a variable? Seventh is, what is user defined exception in Java? Eighth one is, write a program to find sum of elements in a given array. And write a program to reverse an array or string. So that's it for the technical round. So I have mentioned a lot of, like, almost 30 questions related to the technical interview. So you can just go back to the video and take screenshot if you want. Otherwise, you can just prepare from here only. So next we will talk about the MR round questions. So in the MR, the executive will ask you some stress-based questions to examine your work efficiency under pressure. So in MR, they will tend to check your skills, like how will you work under pressure. Like this will be the motive to check your performance. I will tell you few points you should keep in your mind for this round. Like, you should have confidence in yourself that whatever you are answering is the right answer, as the MR will try to confuse you with to check your confidence level. Like, this is a very key point. Like, whatever you are answering, you should be confident enough, like, my answer is correct and I am answering correct answer. The MR interviewer will definitely try to confuse you on that particular answer you are giving. So make sure you are good with your confidence and be firm on your answer. Secondly, he will be judging your working style and ethics under different situations, like sudden change in deadline and conflict issues with the colleagues, leadership quality, how to handle stress. So these are the main different points he will be checking. And last but not the least, you need to have fluency in English, as it is the most important aspect for any TCS employee. Not particularly for TCS employee, but definitely for all the interview, you should be good with your English speaking skills. So let's move forward. We'll see MR questions one by one. So the very first question is, what were your previous posts? So this question is for all the candidates who already have experience. So they will definitely ask you questions on your previous employment, like what was your post there and all things such as. And next one is, what technologies you have worked upon till now. Third question is, what will you do if you are given a team to work with which have internal conflicts within. Fourth is, what will be your reaction if the deadline of your project suddenly decreases, and why should I hire you within 200 students. And what qualities do you have that differs you from others? Suppose you are traveling in a boat with your wife and father and the boat started drowning. Whom will you save first? And the question is, like, what if you are not given your preferred location? So these are the questions from the MR round. And next is, what is one negative thing about yourself? Have you done any certification? On what basis should I judge you before handing over you any project? Are you comfortable in working in team or do you like to work alone? Why are you switching your previous company? So this is for all the experienced candidates. Like, if someone is switching from one company to TCS, then they will ask you this question. So if you are a fresher, they won't ask you this kind of questions. And next question is, your strongest point. What will you do if your work gets continuously criticized by your boss? And how will you manage a team of trainees? How do you define success? And the last question is, how to answer puzzle questions in job interview. So this is the number of questions which I found very common in any MR round. So you can take a screenshot of these questions if you want, so that it will help you while your preparation. So next we'll talk about the TCS HR interview questions. So this round is basically to check your communication vocabulary skills. As TCS has a large number of foreign clients, so it may be possible that you are talking with all the clients for different requirement or changes in their products. So in that scenario, you cannot degrade the reputation of TCS. So it is very important for all that you should be fluent in your English for clearing this round. So make sure you are good with your English communication skills, as this plays a major role in the HR section. So next we'll see the most common HR questions. So we'll go through all these questions one by one. So tell me about yourself. So this is like a definite question, like each and every candidate will face this question. They will ask you, tell me about yourself. So make sure you have prepared a proper answer for this question. Like definitely they will ask you this question. And next, second one is, what are your strengths and weaknesses? Why TCS and who is the current CEO of TCS? What do you know about TCS? Are you comfortable with night shifts? What was the toughest decision you ever had to make? What salary do you expect? Tell me something which you haven't mentioned in your CV. Are you ready for relocation? What are your hobbies? Who motivates you to do a good job? And next are some more questions. Have you led any team, controlled crowd of people efficiently? How do you manage your stress? What do you want to improve in yourself? Where do you see yourself in next 5 years? What are you expecting from this job? Difference between hard work and smart work. What if we don't select you? And what are your plans for higher studies? Next questions are, if I wish to bond you with our company for 2 years, will you join us? If you get a job with a higher package from here, will you do? Your greatest failure, difference between confidence and overconfidence. Can you work under pressure? Do you have any questions? Give an example of your creativity. So these are the most common questions which I found for the TCS HR round. So you can just go and take screenshot if you want, so that it will help you while preparation for the same. So that's it for the today's video, guys. So we have discussed the complete process for TCS interview. We discuss about the importance of CV, like what type of questions should the coding stream and non-coding stream students should prepare, and we also saw a number of questions related to the technical and the managerial and the HR round. So we saw all this type of question, like most common questions we saw. So if you came across any type of query, you can definitely comment all your queries in the comment section below. I will reply to all your queries ASAP. And also I have mentioned the link for the Telegram channel of the FresherBee, and also you can connect to me on Instagram. So I have also mentioned the link for the Instagram channel in the description box of the video. So if you came across any type of query, you can DM me too, or mention all your queries in the comment section below. So I come up with these kind of informative videos on a regular basis, so please don't forget to like the video, and also please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and share this video with your fellow friends who are preparing for jobs like TCS, Infosys and all. So and we'll meet in the next video with one more such informative video. Thank you.